إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with you all. We still continue reading from the book Azamat al-Islam by Mahmoud Mahdi al-Istanbuli. This book talks about the greatness of this deen, the deen of Islam, the deen which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has selected and choose for all mankind and make it to be the only way to be saved and to your way to be to Jannah. And this deen has a lot of fruits and everything it is good. So we point to some of the greatness and the main points of beauty of this deen, so this to increase our faith and to give us more stability in our iman, that we don't exchange this deen for anything of this al-hayat al-dunya. Islam, one of the main characteristic of Islam is al-hayat, to be shy, to be bashful. A person to have this feeling in himself or herself. And haya is not only something related to women. A lot of people think the haya is that women have to have, that people have to have a haya. Other than this, that is not applying to men, and this is not correct. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he himself, he used to be so shy. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be so shy than a virgin girl that never saw a man or a stranger in her life. And as Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, saying that every religion, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ دِينٍ خُلُقٍ وخلق الإسلام الحياء. Every religion have a special characteristic, and the most important characteristic of this Islam is to be shy, to be bashful. A person feel embarrassed to say something bad or to do something that contradict the proper behavior in public or in private, to such a degree that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated in the hadith, al-haya'u wal-imanu qurina jami'a fa'idha rufi'a ahaduhum rufi'a al-akhar, that iman, faith, and being bashful are like twins. They always accompany each other, they always go together like a train tracks, okay? Train track, you understand both of them, okay? So it says that iman and faith and being bashful is like a twins together. If one of them is missing, the other one will be missing. Haya is part of Iman, and Iman take you to no place other than Jannah. One of the main characteristics of this deen that it is against weakness, and Islam teach his followers to be strong and be mighty, and to use this strength and this mighty to defeat the oppressed and to help the weak one and to establish their deen. Not to be strong so you can transgress against others. This is not what the Islam is about. But like it says, there is a saying, it said, if you are not going to be a wild animal, if you are not going to be wild animal, like a wild animal in the forest, the rest of the animals will eat you up. So you have to be strong, you understand, to be able to survive. Because some people, they did not respect anything other than strength and power. You found that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in Quran, Surah number 8, verse number 60, وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ. Prepare for them, prepare for appointments, your enemies, the opposite people of you, okay? All kind of means of strength, okay? And we see nowadays that people only respect the power and might. Each can try to be the superpower, have more weapon, more army, okay? As a result of this, you find the other country is not try to attack them or take their oil or take their land or abuse their people. But when you find other countries, they do not have this strength and this webbing and this preparation, now other countries try to take over. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us at al-mu'min al-qawi khayru wa ahabbu ila Allah min al-mu'min al-da'if. This not only in countries and societies, but even as individual, you have to be strong, and you have to be strong in everything, in your knowledge, in your body, in your iman, in your physical being, okay? So you can establish what is right, so you can convey the message, but not to abuse this strength. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be strong, okay? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us that the strong believer is better and more dearer to Allah than the weak one. We shouldn't be weak in any fashion, in any way. Okay? Some people say, should we be strong also financially? Of course. Why not? Okay? You say, okay, so what's wrong for us to be going to work and go to school and get these degrees? Is nothing wrong. What is wrong is when you make the things takes you away from the remembrance of Allah, make you lose or neglect your basic obligation of the deen. So nowadays they found a lot of women, because the money, they don't wear hijab because they have to meet the job code or not to look a stranger in the job. Okay? This is wrong now. You found some Muslim men, as example, they don't attend Jum'ah. Why? Because the job doesn't allow them. So this is not right. So you have, you understand, to be strong financially, physically, mentally, in your study, in everything, and in your deen. Otherwise, how are you going to invite others if you don't have strong knowledge and solid information? How are you going to convince them? Okay, this is something very important. Yeah. You found nowadays through the media, people winning parties and winning countries and winning people. Why? Because they have the tools that to play on their mind and to convince them. So this shows you the believer have to be strong in every avenue. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, that He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has subjected for your use whatever in the heaven and whatever in the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supplies us with many things, not only in the earth, oil and wood and iron. No, Allah even subjected the air for our own use. Okay? And he found that the early Muslims, they understood this. He found the aeroplane, the first man, you understand, tried to fly, okay, or to make an aeroplane or come about the idea of flying, is a Muslim man, okay, who's not a European or non-Muslims. Why? Because they understood that Allah made things subjected for their own use. But if you are not going to discover things, and if you are not going to try to invent things, you understand, and put things together, and use these things that Allah made it for your own use. Now you be a tail, not a head. Islam always encourages us to have the best characteristic and the best behavior. And understand that always for you to lift yourself up, it takes a lot of effort. To go down, okay, your lower self is easy. You don't, like water in the top of the mountain. You don't need any tools, anything to make it run down. It's going by itself. But when you try to elevate the water to take it to the top of the mountain, now you need energy, you need machineries, okay? So with the same, you want to take yourself to a higher characteristic, to stay away from the haram, to stay away from the riba, to stay away from the zina, adultery, fornication. You need to strengthen yourself, to elevate yourself. But if you want to go down, now you found the shayateen, you found the temptation, you found the haram everywhere. Okay? So it's easy to fall down and to be close to the ground. But for you to go up, you need to strengthen yourself and be strong to elevate yourself. As a result of this, that we find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in surah number 41, verse number 35, وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. Okay? This good characteristic which leads you to paradise and the pleasure of Allah. Allah said, none will achieve it other than those who have endurance, have sabr. You keep struggling to achieve your degree, your position, your whatever that you want. So the same thing, you want to go to Jannah? You have to struggle. You have to stay away from the haram. You have to stay away from the temptation. It's easy to put $5 in a machine, and after this, you found money coming for you, okay? Gambling, lottery ticket, it's easy, okay? But for you to go to work hard and make $7, $10 an hour, it's too much. Same thing, to control your anger, it's not that easy. But can you do it? Of course, okay? Can you stay away from the haram? Allah made means for you. But if you're going to spoil yourself and you are not going to be serious with yourself, your soul will be only dragging, your nafs will be always dragging you to the haram and the wrongdoing. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, only the people who have self-determination and strong in their personality, those people who will be able to achieve Jannah. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us, حفت الجنة بالمكاره وحفت النار بالشهوات. Jannah been surrounded with what? With dislikeness, hardship, okay? But hellfire been surrounded with what? With lust, okay? So you have like a fence. you have to break into this fence to be able to get to the other side. Okay? To get to this yard, you get in the middle of the yard, you have to cross the fence. So Jannah is like, there is a fence around it. What is the fence? That you have to cut it off and climb over it. This likeness. Get up at night for night prayer. Try to be in Fajr, in Jama'ah. To take out of your money, give in charity. You don't like to give from your money. You don't like to get up at night and make salah. You don't want to be fasting and hungry, feel starving. Okay? But these things that you dislike is the things which what? When you cross it, now you can go to Jannah. As for hellfire also have a fence. But this fence is what? Shahawat. Things you understand, desires. Haram. Okay? Drugs. Khamr. Wine. Women. Okay? Nightclubs. All this temptation. So you have to understand that your way to paradise been paved, but for you to cross over it, you have to fight yourself, and you have to strain yourself, and you have to do the things which you dislike it. But Allah gave means and ways that you can go to Jannah. And you have to keep fighting laziness, you have to fight misers, you have to fight these things. This what is going to what? Going to lead you to Jannah. Inshallah, we'll stop here this morning. And hopefully this will be a reminder for all of us, inshallah, that we do our best. And to understand the beauty of this deen, the beauty of this Islam, there is nothing else, anything in this life better than Islam or more truthful than Islam, and more real than Islam. So we have to hold to this Islam ourselves. And also, because we believe in it, we need to invite others to it. And let others see the beauty of it. Any mankind system, you are not going to find the beauty of Islam in it. Islam about cleanliness, truthfulness, about being strong, about being charitable, being good. This is what Islam is about, being clean, you understand? And we have to be grateful and thankful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had opened our eyes and our hearts to Islam. As a result of this, we are not going to give it up for any reason. For any reason. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us firm in the deen. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, and Allah knows best. Any comments, any concern? Is this sister Habiba sitting there? Oh, mashallah. We like on behalf of the mosque and everybody here to welcome you. This is a surprise this morning. I keep looking at you and I don't know, because we have a family just moved last night. Okay, so I thought maybe use the family that we moved last night. But after this, or maybe I'm getting old. Maybe. Which one, I don't know, but welcome in behalf of our gathering here and the mosque. We would like to welcome you back, regardless if you are a visitor or passing through or coming back, whatever. But it's nothing new. People leave Colombia, they come back. Believe me. Even people, I swear by Allah, even they go all the way to Arabia and say, Colombia, Masjid al-Muslimin. So welcome back. Any comments, any question, any concern? All right, as inshallah, alhamdulillah, most of the stuff been, and the heavy stuff, been moved last night. We have two trucks, two trailers. So what's left is little bit. لازال في أغراض يا جمال? لازال في أغراض في البيت هناك? يحتاج سيارتين ولا سيارة واحدة? ها? واحدة سيارة. ومعها تريلر? طيب خير ان شاء الله. So ان شاء الله we're going to, by the time we make our sunnah, We don't want to leave before 6:30 because this is the time we give to the people. So if anybody, inshallah, planning to help, Jazakumullah khairan, we appreciate this. And it's going to be only one trip. And they said, Alhamdulillah, we have most of the stuff. But our advice,